Hi friends, it's Sarah from Ruffles and Rain Boots, and today I'm going to make a real-time craft, a Gnome wine bottle cover. Now I've made this so long ago, let's all pretend that I boop the nose right here, and if you'd like to make them, stick around. As always, please like this video so I know you're here crafting with me. And now I'm going to be brutally honest. Sometimes I buy a bottle of wine for somebody and I want them to see the label. I don't want the whole thing to be covered. I want them to see. So what I did is I created a Shorty McShortykins wine bottle. So I'm using a 7-inch tall hat, 5-inch wide beard. This is either a 1/4 to 1/2 wood bead. We're gonna need scissors, glue gun, felt, which is the premium felt or the thicker felt, and faux fur. Speaking of faux fur, if you want to match the bottle of wine, you can do it in absolutely any shade of fur, any style, any pile. I'm going to be using a white Mongolian fur. Now you can see my template here. This is just easy peasy to create. A 1-inch drop goes to a triangle, and the entire thing is 5 inches wide. That's it. If you're new to cutting faux fur, get yourself a straight edge of some kind. I like to use a razor blade or a box cutter and only cut the fabric backing. Can you do it with scissors? Yes, you can. Is it surprisingly annoying? Yes, it is. All right, so this is the premium felt. It's available in the same area as the kids craft felt. And all you're gonna do is on the fold, put the taller portion of your triangle there, that's 7 inches, and make sure to use about 1/4 inch flat when you trace it. And the reason is because we're gonna put a nice little bell on it. It's like a cat. All right, so do you see that little flat bit up there? That's where I'm gonna put the bell. So I'm going to use embroidery thread without a knot at the end. And I'm just gonna grab one of these little craft bells. I don't know, Michael's, Joanne's, one of them. And I'm just gonna determine which is the front and which is the back. Whatever side the back is, that's the way you're going in. So you're gonna go in, loop your bell, come out the same place you went in or right next to it. Otherwise, what would be the point? Now you can see here, I'm not speeding this up. These are ridiculously quick crafts to make. You can spend all the time in the world decorating them instead of just making them. So you're gonna make sure not to pull this bell too tight because we do want the jingle jangle, and give it a few knots. Grab your scissors, cut it off to about 1-inch-ish. This is gonna be hidden, so it doesn't matter, but we do want it not to catch on any of the corks or screw tops. All right, so all we're gonna do is add a little hot glue to press those guys down. Don't burn yourself like I just did. And then repeat that with the other tail. I'm trying to get through all the videos that I made that I never published. So this is an oldie but goodie. Everybody always loves these when I give them a bottle of wine. All right, so I'll tell you, you're gonna wanna make sure that top part is a little bit over edge. We're gonna maybe fold it over about 1/4 inch. It's a little more obvious down on the bottom. You want to overlap the two triangles on your hat. And we're gonna be able to cut that up and make it all pretty, but we do need that overlap. So you're just going to, I'll just tell you the easier way is not to glue the part that lays down. It's the part that's doing the laying. Start at the bottom and get those overlapped and then move all the way up to the top. I would use a pencil or a small dowel or something to get the bell out of the way so you can be sure not to glue the bell. Also be sure that no hot glue gets like seeps out on the inside because we need that to be open. Right? Makes sense. All right. Just add a little hot glue here and press it down. Again, I use a little tiny, I don't know, dowel. There we go. And then as you can probably guess, the next part is to glue up the center bit. Woohoo! Like I said, this is an easy one. Once you have all these pieces cut, you can actually make 5 or 6 of these in 20 minutes. Ask me how I know. All right, again, I'm just gonna check on the inside to make sure that no glue seeped through, because I wanna make sure I'm not pressing it together and closing up that top. And there we go, we're all good. Now see the very, very bottom there? Let's trim that up and just round it off a little bit. All of this is gonna look really finished because all of the construction is gonna be on the inside right here. So speaking of that construction, you can use anything you want, a pom-pom, a wood bead, a wood ball, a half round, whatever you'd like. Just make sure that you're gluing it securely to the felt and not the fur. We want that to be more prominent. So what we're gonna do is make sure that's all dried, and then you're gonna match up the center of the fur. So that little point, you're just gonna match that up with a nose. And you're going to glue on the fur side. Ready? So just put a little hot glue. Try not to do the whole thing at once. After having made, about 5 of these, I will tell you that it's just easier to do a little bit at a time. Do brush down your fur just to make sure you get it out of the way. Now, for those of you who say, I don't have fur, don't worry. You can use anything, raffia, you can use moss, you can use yarn, rope, cotton mops from the Dollar Tree, whatever you have, just grab it. All right, so we're just gonna finish gluing these two sides down. Do be sure that center is secure before you start tugging on anything, just to make sure that it doesn't move. Ask me how I know. Do y'all ever do that? I swear, sometimes I just get into the groove of things. I love Audible, so I listen to Audible books while I craft. I will get into the book. I'll just have a whole little pile of hot glue burning me. I won't even know it. All right, so now you can see this guy is all done. We're gonna stick him on a bottle. And I would always say, if you're new to gnome making, hey, just grab the fur and kind of pull it together in the bottom. It's gonna make a nice little tailored beard. And guess what? That's it. What do you think of this fun craft? Just let me know in the comments below. Hey, as always, I sincerely appreciate you being here. Please like and subscribe for more crafty fun.